All right, let's talk about rules for significant figures. In this video, I'm going to be talking specifically about a shortcut for the Sig Fig zeros, because I think all students pretty much agree that the zeros are where Sig Figs can get tricky. The numbers 1 through 9 are easy. So this is a mnemonic that I made up that I hope helps you. Okay, so the mnemonic is Ben may try if desperate. And this entire mnemonic is only talking about Sig Fig zeros. So it's not talking about any numerals 1 through 9 because all of those are always significant. This is just kind of talking about the different types of zeros. And so Ben may try if desperate. Now on the left hand side, that's talking about what type of zero you have. And on the right hand side, that's talking about whether or not that type of zero is a Sig Fig. So let's go through and kind of check off whether or not certain types of zeros count as Sig Figs. So first, the B in Ben, that's all the zeros that are before non-zeros. So B for before. And so if you're before a non-zero, the answer to whether or not you're a Sig Fig is no. You are never a Sig Fig if you are before non-zeros. And so next, we're talking about the middle of non-zeros, any zero in the middle of two non-zeros. And for these, the answer is yes. You are always a Sig Fig if you are a zero in the middle of two non-zeros. And then the last type of zero, the tri, that's talking about trailing non-zeros. And so those are any zeros that happen after all your numbers. And so the answer for this is yes, if desperate, and so the mnemonic means it's yes if there's a decimal. So that's all of it. So before non-zeros are not Sig Figs, middle of non-zeros, yes they are, and trailing non-zeros, the answer is yes if there's a decimal. So Ben may try if desperate, and now let's just go over the three examples I have to show you how this mnemonic can work. So on this first example, we're going to check off 4 and 5. Those are definitely Sig Figs because they're not zeros. And now let's start at the left and go over whether or not it's a Sig Fig. So this one happens before all of your numbers. So this is not a Sig Fig. And now we have this one that's in between 4 and 5. So that counts as a middle zero. So yes, that is a Sig Fig. And now we have this zero at the very end. And so that's try if desperate. Yes, there is a decimal point right here. Doesn't matter where the number there is. If it's there at all, then it means that this, yes, it will be a Sig Fig. So now going to our next example, 50,060. Check off 5 and 6. Those are going to be Sig Figs no matter what. And so we have our first two zeros are in between 5 and 6. They're sandwiched. And so they both count as Sig Figs because they're middle. Middle equals yes. And then our last zero is a trailing zero. And there is no decimal point in this number. So this means no. This is not going to be a Sig Fig. And so Ben was not desperate in that case. And now our last example. So check off 3 and 1. Because those are non-zeros. And so our first two zeros on the left-hand side, those are before any numbers, so they're not gonna count. Our next two zeros, they are in the middle, so in the May, yes, they are always Sig Figs. And now we have our two trailing zeros after everything happened. And so in this case, yes, there is a decimal. So it means that yes, these two will be Sig Figs. And so if you remember this mnemonic, Ben may try if desperate, I think that can help. I see students writing it on exams, and so you kind of always remember exactly what types of zeros are Sig Figs. That's all I have for you today. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you learned.